Welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding A Nation Builder's Pride of Place, written by Sanjay Hegde. Now, from examination point of view, this will help you in General Studies Mains Examination Paper 2, plus this will also help you in your essay and interview preparation. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand the thoughts, the ideas, the viewpoints of B.R. Ambedkar. So, I will be taking B.R. Ambedkar as a thinker and will try to deduce his ideas. Now, as far as B.R. Ambedkar is concerned, I will be deducing his ideas on freedom. What is meant by freedom? According to B.R. Ambedkar, his views and ideas on democracy, what democracy was to B.R. Ambedkar, and then I will be discussing about his ideas about the caste system, and at the end of the editorial I will be analyzing whether it is justified to compare him with the political leaders like Mahatma Gandhi, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, Jawaharlal Nehru, etc., or is it justified more to compare him to social leaders like Raja Ram Mohan Rai, Swami Vivekananda, etc. Now, as far as B.R. Ambedkar is concerned, he viewed freedom as something like providing more number of choices. So freedom, according to B.R. Ambedkar, was enhancing or increasing the choices to the people. But according to B.R. Ambedkar, the way the Indian society was working at that point of time, it was not providing the choices to the backward classes. It was not providing the choices to the downtrodden. It was not providing choices to the scheduled castes. It was not providing the choices to the oppressed classes. So, according to B.R. Ambedkar, there was a need to increase the number of choices. There was a need to provide freedom to the people, who are lying in the lower castes, to the people who have been suppressed by the caste system. It was only then possible to transform India as a nation. So, according to B.R. Ambedkar, the real transformation, the complete renaissance of the India could take place if we will be providing the choices, the freedom to the people who are lying in the lower strata of the society. And this is possible only and only if we will be institutionalizing democracy. And according to B.R. Ambedkar, there are two types of democracies. One is a social democracy, the other is the political democracy. According to B.R. Ambedkar, the political leaders of that time, that is Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, etc., they were fighting more for the political democracy. And according to B.R. Ambedkar, democracy is not a way of running the country. Democracy is a social concept. And because of that, there is a need to entrench this democracy socially. Social democracy means you are not letting your caste system to inhibit. You are not letting your caste system to derogate. You are not letting your caste system to degenerate the lower strata of the society. Now, according to B.R. Ambedkar, the Indian society was, or it is based on the system of caste. And this caste system is based on Chaturvarna system. Chaturvarna system says that there is a four-layered division. There are four hierarchies in the Indian societies: the Brahmanas, the Kshatriyas, the Vaishyas, and the Shudras. So there are four divisions in the societies, and it is these divisions that have actually taken the shape of the hierarchies. Hierarchy. Now, divisions are not horizontal. They have actually become vertical. Now, these vertical divisions, they have been also strengthened by the economic aspect attached to them. Like the Brahmanas, they were relatively more richer than the Shudras and the Vaishyas. The economic status of the Brahmanas can be compared with the Kshatriyan class. But as far as the Shudras and the Vaishya class was concerned, they were not economically rich. They were poor, and it is because of that this caste system has not let the social democracy to take place in India. And it is because of this the people, they have not been able to enjoy the freedom. And without the freedom, you will not be able to emancipate India. You will not be able to guide India into the direction of being egalitarian. So it was here where the B.R. Ambedkar differed from Mahatma Gandhi. Now, Mahatma Gandhi was a staunch believer of the caste system. According to Mahatma Gandhi, there should be division in the societies like Brahmanas, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. Now, why this division should be there according to Gandhi? According to him, this provides the functionality to the society. Aap samaj ko chala sakte ho agar achhi tarah se ye kaam bate hue hain ki kaun Brahmana ka kaam karega, kaun Kshatriya ka kaam karega, kaun Vaishya ka kaam karega, kaun Shudra ka kaam karega. So according to Gandhi, Gandhi has viewed the caste system more from the aspect of division of labor. Ki hum organization ko divide karte hain, there is a manager, there is a peon, there is a clerk, there is a CEO. Now, this was how Gandhi was viewing this entire thing from the functional perspective. But B.R. Ambedkar was viewing it from the social perspective. How it was not letting the social democracy to flourish in India. So it is not justifiable to compare B.R. Ambedkar as a thinker, as a leader, with the political leaders. His vision was socialistic. His vision was liberal. His vision was to unleash complete freedom in the society, and it is because of that he had converted from a Hindu to a Buddhist. Because at that point of time, according to B.R. Ambedkar, the caste system, it was more and more dominant in the Hindu religion. Though it is wrong to say that the caste system is prevalent only in the Hindus. Caste system is also prevalent among the Muslims, among the Sikhs, among most of the religions, among the Christians. You will see this caste system all pervasive. But India being more Hindu predominant, Hindu religion predominant, we have seen a leader coming from that community to fight against the ills and the evils of Hindu religion. So, as far as B.R. Ambedkar is concerned, he was a true reformist. He wanted to create a space for the development of the downtrodden and for the backward classes. Now the question comes, is it justifiable to continue with this reservation system? Now why there has been a reservation? The justification of the reservation, it comes from the system of caste. Until and unless we are not going to do away with this caste system, we will not be able to fight this reservation system. Because the foremost justification of the reservation, it comes from the social division of the society. Don't divide the society socially. Don't create walls in the society. The reservation system will automatically go away. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIEAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594. 000000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. Now, to avail the information of the classes that we are offering, you can visit our website, that is eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you've liked this video, please click on the like button. Do share and comment this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice.